गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडे द रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम पार्ट 3 ऑफ आवर चैप्टर. सो हियर ह्यूमन रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम इज शोन हियर अकॉर्डिंग टू द एनसीईआरटी बुक 10th डायग्राम. इन दिस डायग्राम वी कैन सी नासल पैसेज, माउथ कैविटी, फैरिंग्स, लैरिंग्स, ट्रैकिया रिंग्स, देन रिंग्स ऑफ कार्टिलेज, देन लंग, रिब्स एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. अलॉन्ग विद दिस alveoli and respiratory bronchioles are also shown here. Bronchi are shown here, bronchioles are shown here, alveoli sac is shown also here, then diaphragm is also shown in this diagram of NCERT 10th book. Let's take a look upon the 10th book and 11th book now. So let's see this 11th NCERT book. What is shown here? Epiglottis is shown here, larynx is shown here, trachea is shown here, bronchus is shown here, the cut end of the ribs are shown here, these are approximately 9. Lung is shown here, both right lung and left lung are shown here. The right lung is having 3 lobes and the left lung is having 2 lobes. Let's see next thing. If you want further detail from the 10th and 11th NCERT book diagrams, you can go through this diagram. This diagram is having very much detail about the respiratory system. In this, paranasal sinuses are shown here. Frontal and sphenoid sinuses are the paranasal sinuses. Then nose is shown here and parts of nose are also mentioned. Nasal cavity, nasal conchae, nasal vestibule. Pharynx is also shown here. Then larynx is also shown here along with the parts connected with the larynx. Epiglottis, thyroid, cartilage, cricoid cartilage. Then vocal folds are also shown here. You can see here, these are the vocal folds. Trachea is shown here. In that, carina trachea is there. Then main bronchi are shown here. Lingular division bronchi are also explained here and shown here in this diagram in a very beautiful color. Then right lung is shown here. Superior lobe, horizontal fissure is shown here. Oblique fissure is shown here. And the middle lobe and inferior lobe are shown here. So there are basically 3 lobes, of which 2 fissures are there, horizontal fissure and oblique fissure. Then diaphragm is also shown here. Lobar bronchus is also shown here. Superior lobar bronchus, inferior lobar bronchus and middle lobar bronchus, you can see by using these red lines. Then left lung is shown here, which is having 2 lobes, superior lobe and inferior lobe. In that, oblique fissure is there. Then apex of the left lung is also shown here. Cardiac notch is also there where the heart is situated. Then lingula of lung is also shown here. Let's see about the capillary beds in the main diagram of the alveolar sacs. Now here you can see the connective tissue, alveolar sacs, alveolar duct, mucous glands, mucosal lining, pulmonary artery, pulmonary vein, alveoli are also shown here along with the atrium. Let's see about the next point. The next point shows how the lung development or respiratory system development occurs in a human child from the fetus stage to the adult stage. Let's see. Here the blue color, black color, green color and red colored texts are used. What are these actually? Development of the airways and arteries is shown in this diagram. The stages of lung development are shown in blue. All the things that are shown in blue are stages of lung development in humans. So how many stages are there? Embryonic stage of lung development is there, which is 4 to 7 weeks time. Then pseudoglandular development stage is there, which is 5 to 17 weeks. Then canalicular stage is there, which is 16 to 26 weeks. Then saccular stage is there, which is 24 weeks to the term. Then alveolarization occurs from 36 weeks to 21 years approximately, which is shown in blue. Then are correlated to the development of the airways that are shown in black. So stages of lung development in blue are correlated with the airways development, which are shown in black. Here the bronchi are formed approximately at 10, bronchioles are formed approximately at 4, respiratory bronchioles 4, then alveolar ducts 4, saccule 1 and then alveoli forms. So let's see What are the red things? The arteries are shown here with the stages of lung development correlated to the development of airways with the arteries in red. How many kinds of arteries form? Extra pulmonary artery form during the 34 days. Lobular arteries form during the 44 days. Pre-acinar arteries form, which are conventional plus supernumeraries, 5 to 17 weeks. Then intra-acinar arteries form from 18 to 25 weeks time period. Then alveolar duct arteries form between 25 weeks to 18 months of postnatal period. Then microvascular maturation occurs in between 36 weeks to approximately 21 years. Alveolar capillaries also mature from 36 weeks to approximately 21 years of human age, both in male and female of humans. So what is this? On an average, an airway of a human lung ends in an alveolar saccule after 23 generation. Okay, the airway of human lung ends in an alveolar saccule means from a normal airway to form an alveolar saccule, there are about 23 generations required. Then, however, due to the shape of the lung, a range of 18 to 30 generations has been observed. Pre-acinar arteries are formed out of a capillary plexus surrounding the growing lung buds, which are known as vasculogenesis process. Intra-acinar arteries grow by angiogenesis. The generations shown here are the generations of cell division. Note that the generations shown here, these 23 generations or 18 to 30 generations, these are cellular generations or cell division generations. Next, let's see about the actual differentiation of the respiratory system cells. In this trachea, differentiate into bronchus. The bronchus differentiate into bronchiole. From trachea, bronchus up to bronchiole, this is known as conducting zone of gases. Here, the gases are conducted. Then, next thing, the zone is respiratory bronchiole, alveolar duct and alveolar sac. This zone is known as respiratory zone, where the gases are exchanged, which are conducted by trachea, bronchus and bronchiole. This diagram will be helpful for you. You can pause this and learn about this. This is the main differentiation pattern of lungs and the bronchial system inside the lungs. Let's see the anatomy of bronchus. How a bronchus forms, which things are there in the formation of bronchus. In bronchus formation, from the outside, there are cartilage plates. Just inside, there is smooth muscle. Then a mucus lining is there through the inside. Then ciliated lining is also there. Bronchial lumen is there. The lumen is known as bronchial lumen. And in between these, from the outer layer and the inner layer, in between these, the blood vessel networks is present. Next thing, trachea and the major bronchi of the lungs are shown here. In this, thyroid cartilage part is present. Cricoid cartilage part is present below the thyroid cartilage part. Then annular intercartilaginous ligaments are present just below the cricoid cartilage. In between the thyroid cartilage and cricoid cartilage, medium cricothyroid ligament is present, which is just in between thyroid cartilage and cricoid cartilage. Let's see about the next part. Mucosa of posterior tracheal wall is shown here after dissecting the wall. Then after that, right superior lobar bronchus is shown here and left superior lobar bronchus is shown here. So let's see about the right superior lobar bronchus and how it is divided into its branches. So to this superior lobe, there are B1, B2 and B3 branches. These three are branches of right superior lobar bronchus, okay, to the superior lobe, B1, B2, B3. Then middle lobar bronchus is shown here, in which B4 and B5 branching is there. Then at the bottom to the inferior lobe, these branches go, that are B6, B7, B8, B9 and B10. Then the right and left main primary bronchi as is shown here. Let's see about the left superior lobar bronchus. In the left superior lobar bronchus, B1 plus B2 superior division bronchus is present. In that, B3 is also there, lingular bronchus is also there. Then B4 and B5 goes to the lingula. Then B6, B7 plus B8, B9, B10 goes to the inferior lobe. So basically there are in the left lung two lobes, the superior lobe and the inferior lobe. in the superior division B1 plus B2 plus B3 plus B4 plus B5 glow. But here lingular bronchus is also there as a part of superior lobe. So here the lingular bronchus contains B4, B5 division of the bronchus. Then let's see about the next diagram. The next diagram shows very, very detailed view of primary, secondary and tertiary bronchus. You can see here, but if you are unable to see the small alphabets and numbers, let's go towards the next diagram. In this diagram, you can easily see that how these divisions occur. Okay. So let's see. B3 is divided into A, C, B. Then B1 plus 2 divided into A, B, C. Upper division of bronchus is shown here. Lower division of bronchus is shown here. B4 divided into A, B. B5 is also divided into A and B. Then B8 is also divided into A and B. B9 is divided into A and B. B10 is divided into A, C and B. Then lower lobe bronchus is shown here. B6 is divided into A, B and C. Here also at the right part of the lung, B1 is divided into A and B, which are shown here with the help of arrows. B2 is divided into A and B. B3 is divided into A and B. B6 is divided into A, B and C. B4 is divided into A and B. Then B8 is divided into A and B. B9 is divided into A and B. B10 is divided into A and B and C. So the numbers and the alphabets are used here also at the right lung differentiation of bronchus and at the left lung differentiation of bronchus into primary, secondary and tertiary bronchi. So what is this diagram? This diagram is about primary and secondary and tertiary bronchi and their differentiation along with numbering. Let's see about the next thing. The next thing shows very, very detailed view of the respiratory bronchioles. Here you can see the terminal bronchiole after the complete differentiation of primary bronchus into secondary and secondary to tertiary. At the end, the respiratory bronchioles start. So this is terminal bronchiole from where the respiratory part starts. Let's see. It is made up of surrounding of smooth muscle, elastic fibers. Alveolus are also present at this structure. Then first order, second order and third order respiratory bronchioles are shown here, in which alveoli appear at this level. So respiratory bronchiole level is the level at which alveoli appears. Then the first order, the second order and the third order are shown here. Just observe the cursor. The first order respiratory bronchioles are shown here. The second order respiratory bronchioles are shown here and the third order respiratory bronchioles are shown here. Okay. Then at the end, alveolar ducts form to connect alveolar sac. Alveolar sac contains alveoli. The alveoli contains various small grape-like structures where each grape is having pore-like structure. That pore-like structure is known as pores of Cohen, which is structure of intrapulmonary airways. So these are intrapulmonary airways. Other information is also shown here that we have already studied.